is University of Nigeria, Nsukka. Several years ago, I came to this school as a student. Before I came to this school as a student, I was physically challenged at the age of 3. And between the ages of 3 and 10, I was a beggar in my village. Everybody knew me. I was crawling on the floor for 7 good years. I will hang something on my neck. I will go to the marketplace to beg. That was what I was doing for 7 years. And for these 7 years, all my age mates were already in school. I was despised. I was nobody. Until one day, I decided to go to school. And when I got to school, the headmaster made a mockery of me and said to my father, "Why did you bring this one here? What did he come here to do?" He said to my father, "He can't be a student. So take him back home. He can't be a student." And then I asked the man, "What will I do? If you want to maximize who you are in life, you don't tell stories of what has happened to you. You tell stories of what will I do to come out of what has happened to me?" That's the question. So I asked the man, "What will I do?" He said, "Go and learn how to walk." And for 1 year, I was learning how to walk with this stick. And I'll take a step and I will fall. Young people, listen to me. On the journey to success, you're going to fall several times. But when you fall, you're going to get right back on your legs. You're going to write an exam several times, but you won't give up until you pass that exam. You're going to go for interviews several times. You're going to be rejected, but each time they reject you, you return. You're going to set up businesses several times. You're going to make mistakes, but a mistake does not define who you are. And so from primary school, working with a stick, I came to this University of Nigeria, Nsukka. And when I entered this school, life was a hell for me. No money to eat, nothing. And then, to make matters worse, I didn't have a leg to walk with. And then I had a terrible experience after I lost my dad. A lecturer, I went to ask him a question in the class. And this man said to me, "Bring the question to the class. I want everybody to gain from this question." So I came to the class. And he said to me, "Come and stand in front of the class at the mass communication department at the Faculty of Arts here." So I stood in front of the class. And this man looked at me and said, "You asked me a question." I said, "Let me ask you questions too." He said to me, "When you were entering the university, where did you pass?" I said, "Sir, I passed through the university gate." He said, "When you were passing, who did you see?" I was wondering, what was the need? I said, "Sir, I saw the transporters, the Okada people." Said, "Yes." "Who else?" "I saw the security people." "Yes." "Who else?" "I saw those hawking." He said to me, "Think very well. Who else did you see?" I said, "Sir, I saw those who were begging." He said, "Describe them for me." So I described them to him. I said, "Some of them are blind. Some of them are physically challenged." This lecturer pointed me in my face and said to me, "That's where people like you stay, at the gate." He said to me, "Pack your things. Go to the gate. Sit at the gate and beg." He said to me, "You will never become anything. Your place is at the gate." He said to me, "Look around the class. Is there anybody with a stick in their hand? Can I share to you? I left this school with a first class." Listen to me, young people. I left this school with a CGPA of 4.86. Listen to me, young people. Today, as I stand here, I have a PhD. I am a lecturer and I teach in 2 different schools. I have cars that I drive on my own. I have family, I have a wife and children. By the special grace of God, I have traveled around the world. The last time I got to UK, I got to London Heathrow Airport with the same stick in my hand. That same thing for which they mocked you, that's the same thing God will lay hand on and elevate you. So when I got to Heathrow, they sent a white man to come pick me. He was carrying a placard with my name, Dr. Kasarachi Innocent. So when he came, I said, "Hi, my name is Dr. Kasarachi Innocent." He took a step and said, "Are you sure?" "Oh, come on. The Bible says in Psalm 126 verse 1, when God turned again our captivity, we were like them that dreamt." He said to me, "Are you sure?" One day, I was walking with my wife on the road. My wife is not tall. My wife is long, very long. Very, very long. So I was walking with her. And then somebody drove his private car and parked and stopped. And horn, blow horn, pim, 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 pim. So my wife said,
Go now, go and check. Now your friends will get car. So I went to him. I said, yes, sir. He said, sorry. Where are you guys going? You and that's your sister. Where are you going? I said, we are going to some place. He said, go and call her. I want to give two of you a lift. So I went back to my wife. And I called her. I said, the man is calling us. So she came. And the man wound down the glass. I said, hi, sweetheart. How are you? Can you enter the front? Let your brother enter the back. Can you give a clap to Jesus? Can you celebrate Jesus for me? Celebrate Jesus for me. Say, can you enter the front? Let your brother enter the back. My wife said, are you crazy? This is my husband. And the man put up the car and said to me, Oga, now your wife? I said, yes. He said, how manage? I said, I don't know how manage, but she's my wife. I don't know how manage. Listen to me, young people. When you live your life for God, God will give you what your hand cannot get for yourself. When you give your life, when you dedicate yourself to the master, God will give you a miracle.